And I look at it as psychological warfare. And that's where I started learning that life is one big psychological warfare that you play on yourself. You play on yourself, man. The most important conversation I ever had is with myself. And the shit I was telling myself was so fucked up. It was so wrong. It was so misguided. And other people start to write that dialogue for you also. And it starts to be what you say to yourself every single day. And I started creating a whole nother warfare. A whole nother battle started becoming. I was like, oh, hang on a second, Goggins. You have these tools. You have these tools. Your life was basically the perfect grounds for training for where you need to go in your life. All the beatings, all the bullying, all the, you know, you going through learning disabilities, all the struggles. It was the absolute perfect training ground for you to go to where you need to go. And that's how I started looking at my life versus woe is me, poopy pants, kick a rock down the street mentality. It was, nah, God just hooked you right the fuck up. He hooked you right up, man, with the perfect place. You were training for the first 18, 19, 20 years. You were training for this stuff, man. You have the advantage of everybody else versus, my God, they're so above me. They came from a great family. Mom and dad love them. They didn't have a learn. They didn't start. They didn't struggle. No, man, your struggle is what made you who you are now. So I started flipping this into a whole different. I started being a master of what I was scared of. I was scared of my mind, and I became literally a master of that mind. And that's what now, from now on, it sets me apart from most people. I started diving into that. Pursuit of Happiness. Yeah, it's a great movie. It wasn't like Pursuit of Happiness, man. Like where the guy struggles and then he gets over it and he makes it. I fell on my ass. I thought I got the top of Mount Everest, and Mount Everest just fucking slide right underneath me, man. I was like, God, dog, I gotta start from scratch again. Scratch became my friend, literally, man. So, you know, that's how you put in the book, man. Just going up, going down, going up. Just the real raw version of how my life was. It was so in depth to go back through your life with a fine tooth comb that I almost got embarrassed to even put it out there to people. That's what you don't understand, man. Like, even me right now to talk to you, I'm in the car for a fucking hour getting pumped up because I'm a shy, introverted, leave me alone type of guy. Like, I'm still that motherfucker who is 6 years old, you know, at a play who can't say his line because I know I'm gonna stutter in front of five people. So I walk off the stage. That's still me. So I'm not sadistic, man. I'm focused on what I have to do to stay locked into the game of life. And that's why I tell people, man, I go there. And I'll tell you this, I started really realizing that when I started overcoming myself, I started getting around these real alpha males, these hard, hard men. And I always put people way above me when I was growing up. Like, my God, they had to have a lot more than me to get to where they're at. And a lot of them did. But once you get around the best of the best of the best people, you can kind of start breaking them down and realizing, man, you're just as fucked up as me. Like we all have, but all you did was you hit it better. Your upbringing, your mom and dad, your society, the way you were raised, it hit it better than mine. You weren't the only black kid, or there was like five in a school. You know, I can't hide. Going through buzz, I was the only black kid. You can't hide. But I started realizing just because I look different than you, a lot of you motherfuckers can't hide either. So it started giving me courage through watching people that we all have a story. We all have a jacked up life in one way or another. Some of us don't have the guts to talk about it though. And that's where I found the guts to talk about mine. I used to look at my life from a different vantage point. And when you're in all the muck and you're just walking in muck and walking in muck and walking in muck, you don't see that if you look off to the fucking left of the muck, there's a sidewalk, brother. Get off of it. You have your head down looking in this muck. Once I saw the sidewalk, got the sidewalk, I got a little break and I got a different vantage point. And then from the sidewalk, I found a cliff. Then I found a mountain. I got way up high on top of my life and looked back down on it and said, okay, I got to figure this out, man. I'm not going anywhere. I'm starting to lie. I'm starting like, so when you have a messed up foundation, I started lying about everything. I wanted people to like me. I wanted to be accepted in some society of life, some social society. And I was like, man, this isn't the right way. I messed up here, I messed up here, I messed up everywhere. And so I realized the worst thing that happened to me is I lost myself. I never had myself, I never found myself. I had no self-esteem. So I knew through working out and through learning, because it took a lot for me to learn also, I started finding self-esteem. Once I found that, that's when doors started opening up. I stopped caring about people, that what they thought, being judged. Wow, if I say this, if I started right now, are you gonna make fun of me? I stopped caring about that. And that's when my life started really changing for me, slowly but surely.
Rome wasn't built in a day. We all know that. Everyone hears that. But Rome also didn't fall apart overnight either. It took hundreds of years for Rome to reach its peak, but it also took time, hundreds of years, for Rome to decay and fall apart. And that is representative of life, because you don't achieve worthwhile goals quickly or easily. They take time. They take struggle. They take relentless pursuit day in and day out. That's what it takes. But also, things don't usually fall apart quickly either. At least at first, it's a slow process. A little slip here, a little setback over there, a little wearing down of discipline and will over time. That's the thing. Success and failure are generally slow processes. Either slowly building things up or gradually tearing them down. And that's why I say you've got to pay attention. You have to watch. You have to watch every single second. Because those seconds, they turn into minutes. And minutes turn into hours, and hours turn into days, and days turn into years. And so, that second that just went by, that counted. And so did that second. And so did that one. And in those precious seconds, you were either building or you were decaying. You were either gaining ground or you were losing ground in that second, and in every second. Every second counts. So, make every second